Red Cross said it is experiencing a severe blood shortage and that they need donors now. So joining us more to talk about that from Stonington, happy to have John Godin, spokesperson for the Red Cross, joining us to talk about the need for blood and how you can help. John, good morning. How are you this morning?
Good morning, Tim. I'm doing well. And thank you, Fox 61, for having us on this morning.
Yeah, and glad we can talk about this. And we were talking a little bit right before we came back on the air, and it seems like certainly because of COVID-19, now the need for blood has gone back up, but maybe people are still a little hesitant to go out and donate as much as they have in the past. Not to say that that was even all that much.
Right. I think what's happened is, you know, people are finally getting out. They're finally moving on with their lives with respect to the pandemic. The problem is, what's happening is there's a lot of elective surgeries and people deferred a lot of treatments for healthcare that are now starting to happen. So now you have an issue where there's a need for blood and the need obviously starts exceeding the supply. But what's also happening is you have people who are going on vacation, getting involved with summer camps, meeting family and friends that haven't been able to over the last 12 months. And now you have fewer people donating, not because they don't want to, but because it's not top of mind. So what we're trying to do today and this week is bring out the fact that there is a need for blood. And we'd love to have people to who's given in the past, consider giving again in the future, and those who have never given before to consider giving for the first time.
Okay, so who can and cannot donate? And also curious how COVID-19 and or vaccination status plays into that.
Well, vaccination doesn't really affect someone's ability to give blood. As long as you know, if you've been vaccinated and you know that what vaccine you were given, you just have to declare that. You also have to make sure that you have no symptomatic occurrences from that vaccine in the last couple of weeks. You're available to give blood now.
No restriction. What types of blood are used? I think, what is it, O negative is considered the universal blood type, but do you ever have specific needs for other specific blood types outside of that?
There is a need for all blood types. O negative is a universal blood. If the emergency room needs blood, they will go to O negative first to give to any patient that needs blood for which they do not know what the blood type is. O positive is the most common blood type, and O positive can be given to any blood type who has been identified as Rh positive. So any kind of O blood is desperately needed now. And it's typically the type of blood that is retained by most hospitals to treat patients.
And real quick, how can people make an appointment to donate?
They can make an appointment three ways. Yep. They can go to redcross.org to schedule an appointment online. They can use the American Red Cross donor app and schedule it on their smartphones, whether it's an iOS or Android device. And for those more comfortable with phone reservations, they can call 1-800-RED-CROSS and make the appointment via phone.
There you go. And we got the number there on your screen, 1-800-RED-CROSS. John, thank you so much for taking the time to get the word out. Hopefully we can help make a dent in this deficit.
Thank you, Tim. We appreciate your help in this effort.